Hello everyone, welcome back. For today's video tutorial, I'm going to have a look over a new sensor that is ADS1115, and to have a better view over this sensor, what we're going to do is to log in to the website that is controleverything.com, and here we have to search on for this particular sensor, and let's see what we got for this particular sensor. And we got, it's a 16-bit 4-channel precision analog to digital converter, and you can see these are some more features which you can add for this particular sensor. Now you can also add to cart. You can purchase this sensor from this website, from here. Well, for the interfacing part, I will be taking care of the sensor ADS1115 with a BeagleBone Black, and the language platform will be C language code. And to get the code, go to the source tab, and here comes the C code sample, as you can see, and you can download the code sample as a zip file from here. And also you can have the code from github.com, and you have to go to the repository that is Control Everything Community. After that, we need to put some hardware connection setup together, and let's see what we got there. Well, for the hardware connection setup, the first thing we require is the BeagleBone Black, which you are able to see on my screen. And this here is an I2C shield for the BeagleBone Black. Now this is available on the website controleverything.com, and the real reason we are using this shield is to make connections easier with other I2C devices. So for that, what we require is to gently place this I2C shield over the BeagleBone Black and make a connection just like that. For the power up setup, we require two things. The first is a mini USB cable just like this, and gently insert it over here. It is very useful to power up the BeagleBone Black. Now to power up the I2C shield, we require a 5-volt adapter, which you are able to see on my screen, and gently inserted in here. Now for an option for the internet connection, there are two mediums. The first is an Ethernet cable or a LAN cable, and the second is this, a wireless nano USB adapter. Now what do we require is our sensor, that is ADS1115, and this here is a connecting cable. Now make the connection among the sensor and the cable, and make sure that the brown wire of the cable should be connected to the ground terminal of the sensor, and same rule has to be applied to the I2C shield. So we are done with all the connections we need. Now what do we require is to have a look over the code. Coming to the interfacing section, first of all the step is to log in to github.com, and after that we have to search on for the repository, that is Control Everything Community. After going on, we have our sensor, that is ADS1115, and here it is. It's analog to digital converter, and here comes the C code. But before that, let's have a look over the instructions we need to follow to pursue this code. And the first step, we have to set up the device, that is the BeagleBone Black, and the relevant information and instructions are provided on beagleboard.org. Please follow it carefully, and then the next step is to download or git pull the code onto BeagleBone Black. This is the command for C code compilation, and this is to run the C code. Please note it down carefully. After that, get back to the C code. As you can notice on my screen, we have .c extension file. Then in the code, we have included some of the header files. As you can see, we have libraries here, and in the void main function, we have created an I2C bus. As you can see, we are going to check whether the bus is open or present or whether it is not. And after that, we have to check for the I2C device and whether the address of the sensor, that is 0x48. Now for the writing section part, we are going to select the configuration register having address 0x01. And the command we are going to set is to make sure that we have two terminals. One is for positive, that is AIN0, and one is for negative, that is AIN1. And we have range of voltage, that is plus minus 2.048. voltage. We have continuous conversion mode, 128 SPS, and it comprises of 0x84, 0x83, which goes for 16-bit data we are going to send for one configuration register. And then here comes the writing command, which is here. After that, we have a sleep of 1 second, then we are going to read, as you can see, data from the register 0x00 and its raw ADC MSB along with the LSB, and here comes the reading section part here. Then we have to convert the data we have just read, and it's according to the guidelines provided in the data sheet for ADS1115. At the very end of our code, we have output data to be displayed onto the screen, which is the digital value of analog input, which actually is the raw value. So please have a closer look on this code, as it's a very simple and generalized code. Now what do we require next is to have a look over the practicality of this code along with sensor.
Now let's have a look over the working part, which is very interesting in itself. And for that, we have to copy this entire code of the C Azulang code. And after that, we have to open up the terminal for the BeagleBone Black we have just connected. And here we have the command, as you can see on my screen. We have to create it. First of all, we have to create the file, and it's a .c extension file, which is the C language code, as you can see on my screen. And we have to paste the entire code here. And after that, we have to save it. Now to compile the code, as you can see on my screen, we have this part and hyphen O. This is the command, as you can see. And let's see what we got here in the compilation, and it's done. Now for the command, this is the command, as you can see on my screen. This is to run the C code, and let's have it. And what we got here is a digital value of analog input. And I run the command again and again. We have the value 0, which clearly means that the ends are open, there is no connection. But instead, when I apply a AA battery of 1.5 volt source, as you can see, and I run the command and build it, and we have the digital value of analog input. When I run again and again and one more time for a specific value, you can see there is not much change. And it's, the value is almost constant because there is a battery connected among the terminal 1 and 0. And this is how the sensor responds. Now the next step is to have a look over the applications and the benefits of this sensor.
The ADS1115 is a precision analog to digital converter with 16-bit of resolution offered, and is designed with precision, power and ease of implementation in mind. The ADS1115 feature an onboard reference and oscillator. Data are transferred via an I2C compatible serial interface. 4 I2C slave addresses can be selected. Due to these prominent features, it is useful in a lot of applications like portable instrumentation, consumer goods, battery monitoring, factory automation and process controls, and a lot more. Well, you can have this sensor and you can purchase it from controleverything.com, and you can get the code from resource tab. From this site, you can download the code as zip file. Also, you can get the code from github.com, and the repository there is controleverything community. In the end, I would like to make it clear that if you have any doubt regarding any part of this sensor video, you can have your queries on controleverything.com, and you can post your comments on the community page on this website. For articles and blogs, you can have a look over on instructables.com. And to subscribe more video tutorials like this, you can have a look over our YouTube channel. In the end, I hope you enjoyed this video and had a good one yourself. Thanks a lot for watching.